All right, here we are. We're back live in Fort Cronkite, California, and we're redoing a shower here for one of the residents at the Marin Wildlife Center. I've already cleaned this wall that you could see here, and then as I pan back to the right here, you could see the wall I haven't cleaned, and you could see the pink, the black stuff, all the gross, pardon my usage of words, but all the gross shit there, body oil, soap, scum, mildew. It's pretty disgusting, so the best way to clean this is like this. I'm going to show you. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is get your cleaner. Move the damn hose out of your way. You always start from the top, work your way to the bottom. You let your product work for you, so you always get everything wet. I'm using an acid that's only made for white grout. If you use it on any other color grout, it'll bleach the color out. So this is an acid that I use. So we're gonna clean it in sections. So I'm gonna do this top half here, which you can see it isn't as bad down here because usually, and you'll notice in your shower alone, everything's like a pattern, so the water bounces off. So usually the nasty shit's from the waist down, give or take a little bit, but you can still see how pink all this is right here. So what the acid will do compared to like bleach-based cleaners, like Tilex and all this other crap, is you're bleaching your soap scum and your body oils clear, where the acid eats it, attacks it, breaks it down, and gets rid of it. Okay, so that's the difference between using like bleach and something. So bleach does what exactly it says it's gonna do. It bleaches things, it makes things white, you know. So it doesn't necessarily, I'm not saying it's a bad cleaner, but like I said, I prefer the acid because I know I'm giving my customers a better thing. So you got to use your old trusty brass tip brush. Was it just leaking water?
Mm-hmm.
Just put your bucket over there and then just underneath where it'll be. So now that I have my acid soaking and eating it, you can see it's running down. All that does is help you out. So you got to take your brass, not steel, because brass is soft, okay? And I'm not even applying a lot of pressure. It's just pretty much more the action of it. So you do all the way up. And like I said, I'm doing a start and stop line right here, and then I'll do the bottom portion. Remember, your brass tip brush is your best friend. Okay, now you always cross your T's, you come back. So it starts to get a little dirtier down here, so I get a little more aggressive here. But as I work my way back to the top, it's just almost more like the old once over. There isn't really too much up here. So really, it's all about the detail. When you're cleaning your own shower, you know, you want to feel like you're getting clean in here. All right, so I used the brass brush, so now you got to hit it again. Same thing, you start from the top. Go ahead, let the acid clean your shower for you. Let it get it everywhere. Let the acid start to eat the hard water, the calcium, body oil, soap, scum, just all the nasty shit that gets in showers. You know, you gotta think about showers. You know, if you take a couple showers a day, maybe even if two or three people use the shower over 7 days a week, you know, 30 days out of the month, this thing gets fucking 100 showers a month times 12 months. I mean, you get the idea of, you know, showers take a punishing. You know, they get beat up, they get used a lot. As you can see, there isn't a fan in here to ventilate or anything, so I'm pretty sure, you know, the ventilation here sucks. So remember, it's all about the details, so make sure you get in the edges and the cracks and the creases real good. At the end, that'll give you a better job. So what I'm doing now is I'm just going over it. Remember, when you use a brass tip, you have to come back with this brush to kind of knock down the gray little film that the brass will leave. All right, so the top part, done. So I'm gonna come down here and repeat my process here. I'm gonna get all this wet. See all this pink shit in here? See all that? See, the acid will get rid of it. And it's also on the tile here. It's just harder to see because the tile's white. But there's like a layer of soap scum on here that I can see it, like it's turned to kind of gray looking. It's really hard to see. But if you look, at the acid start to eat it. Look at that. See that? So the acid, it really does its thing. I'm using it straight. I'm not diluting it just because this is so dirty. So same thing. You want to get your brass brush. Scrub this sucker all the way down. Remember, you want to let the acid work for you. You want to let it eat it. Yeah, you got to put the elbow grease, but it's more about letting the acid do its thing. I got a shower at my own house, and every 2 weeks, I got to start cleaning or it starts to turn to this. It's just how it is. Everybody's got a shower, and it gets gross. Especially, man, you got kids and a lot of people using it. Like I said before, that thing will get abused and used real fast. So I'm trying to do this in real time so you guys get an idea that it doesn't take your whole freaking day. Every couple of weeks, at once a month, you just got to get in here and scrub the damn thing. So I'm trying to let the camera run through as I do it so you can get an idea that, okay, it just took the guy 10 minutes, you know? And your shower will look like new. So it's about using the proper products and the proper cleaning technique. And like anything, at the end, you'll have the best result. So now I'm going to take it. You can hit the top of the tile with it. This will help get the little soap scum and stuff that's built up on top of it. And like I said, I could just see the soap scum on the tile down here where it's really bad. Now we come back with our trusty nylon here. It'll clean the soap scum, the hard water, all this shit off of the metal here. So remember, you're doing this because the brass tip leaves metal. So you gotta come back, like not metal, it leaves like a gray little film from the metal. Brass. So what you can see is down here around the bottom, some guy obviously replaced the tiles. You can see they're a different color. But he used black grout. All he had to do was clean it, and he just saw that it was white. So I'm actually going to dig all this out and regrout it. And we'll do that after we get her clean. But yeah, that's the type of work people are giving people. People actually paid for that. Accepted it, so we are going to try to salvage it. We're going to try to salvage it and make it look the best we can. In this line of work, you got to take what you're given. So same thing, if you look down here, you can see this little shower track. So I just kind of popped it off because it's disgusting. If you take your acid and you gently just start cleaning it, you can see all little chunks of ass, feet, and corn chips coming out this mower. So you can see, this is all the detail. This is the areas that, you know, house cleaners and certain people aren't gonna take this off and take the time to really get in here. And as you can see, look at all the chunks. There's like chunks of mold, just pink soap, some body oil, just same stuff that's in the grout. It's just here on this little plastic thing here. So this is where we separate ourselves from the rest of the people that try to do what we do. Same thing, if you get in here, right along this edge here, see that big wad of chunk of dirt back in there? That's all the gross, nasty stuff, people. That's the stuff that most people just leave. Like I said, I'm gonna clean it, and if you watch closely, just take a little acid to it. And you can see it, just the acid just eats it, melts it. We could clean it. Look at all that. Look at that. See that? That's chunks of ass, feet, body oil, skin. Look at all that shiznit. Ugh. Sometimes it's gross, people. Sometimes it's gross. So see all this dirt and mold along the rubber here? So same thing. We're gonna hit this. Clean this little rubber piece here. Real gently. Use a little brass to get the little nooks in the hard areas here. It'll also, you can simply eat the hard water off of the glass. So you see all this hard water. The acid will just, same thing, it'll eat all the soap scum, body oils, the hard water, the calcium, any of the stuff that gets on here. So this is the same thing, ladies and gentlemen, this is the detail. If you like detail, this is how you do it. Get that corner, see that corner, get that corner. Get that corner! Gotta get him. And the acid, same thing, it'll slowly eat it and do its thing. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and rinse for a second here. You can already see as I melt all this shit off of here, you can see how much better. Look at all that chunks of food coming out. See all that? That ain't food, but you can see it. It's chunks of life, I don't know. Remember, you don't want to leave the acid sitting on metal too long. It will start to corrode it and eat at it a little bit. So rinsing and stuff's real important. We got the grout clean on the walls. I've hit the edges really good. All we got to do now, as you can see, that thing looks great and all that nasty shit out of it. Then I'll slide it on back down. All right, we're done. We got everything cleaned. We detail cleaned it. We regrouted along the bottom. I regrouted this big, huge grout joint you can see here, which obviously isn't regular, but whoever did the kind of jimmy rig job before me didn't have it even. So I made it nice and even. At least it's clean. It'll dry a lot lighter because it's an antique white color. You can see the stuff on the bottom already drying out. It should match a lot better. So we made the best of what we had with what we had here. So I'm happy with it. It's definitely spotlessly clean. If you like what we did, you have any questions, you should subscribe, you should like us, you should share us. Most important of all, constantly drop in tons of good knowledge and good stuff to know how to clean your showers and maintain them and keep them looking good. So,
see you next time. Here. I'm standing here at the Marin Wildlife Mammal Center here in Fort Cronkite, California. I'm here with Jason. He works here at the Mammal Center. He's the one that actually found me, so I'm going to cut right to it. What made you look for us?
You had a solid reputation online and you got back to me really quickly, which I appreciated, and price was totally fair, and you just did an awesome job out here for us, so we appreciate it.